Good morning. Welcome to Almas Market Morning. This is Jairam. The yo-yo in global equity markets has continued, with yesterday being a strong up day, driven mainly by bargain hunting recovery in tech-heavy Nasdaq, which had lost about 8% from the peak. Notwithstanding this, market is still in an uncertain zone, as there are many headwinds like debt ceiling talks in passe. Fed policy, which will depend a lot on upcoming jobs data and the inflation. Fears over debt ceiling talks failing or keeping the bond yields higher. And yields are also rising in Europe and UK. In fact, UK 10-year yields are now higher than what we saw in March 2020. Hence, GBP has made a strong recovery from the lows of 1.34. As for the inflation, the Brent trading comfortably above 80. Is keeping everyone on the edge, with natural gas prices going through the roof with the shortages. So that will keep the markets really tentative. Reserve Bank and New Zealand raised policy rate by 0.25%, but the move was expected, hence not much of a reaction is seen in the currency. Overall, I think dollar is in a sideways range, but the moves are quite divergent. Weak against commodity currencies, strong against EMs and yen. We need to wait for the jobs data on Friday to see if we resolve into a broader general trend. Our bias for dollar is definitely on the stronger side in short term due to many risk averse factors. On the gold, it is subdued because of rising yields. At the same time, the zone between 1710 to 1750, we are hearing central bank interest to accumulate gold. So in case we do see a higher yield from here, we may drop to 1710, 1720, but I do not see much below that level. INR is in a slow weakening trend. Fears of power shortage in India also is rising due to high coal prices. That may necessitate more import of fossil fuels, and higher crude prices will definitely reflect in higher inflation, keeping the rupee weak. In this context, RBI's policy that concludes on Friday is very important. I feel there will be a tightening move by RBI. It can be not exactly a preemptive move because we've already seen inflation rising. So they might fall behind the curve if they don't do anything. I expect the rupee to move in 74.50 to 74.70 range today, but an eventual test of 75 looks on the cards. Thank you.
Thanks, Jairam. This is Pankaj. So decent moves in real consumables like crude oil. Both the crude oil, Brent crude oil, made a three-year high yesterday. It traded higher than $82 per barrel, whereas the WTI crude oil made a 8-year high and traded closer to $79 per barrel. These are interesting moves in a space where people are thinking that we are shifting back to renewable energy, the technology is shifting, and we will be moving towards all those electronic vehicles and all. Looking at that, these moves are looking a very, very phenomenally good moves. It seems that people started believing in that the energy crisis brewing. As we here in local also, people are saying that the coal reserves are at the lowest level. So these are very, very important development. The rally continues to with crypto also. Cryptos are moving at a very good pace. Bitcoin crossed 51,000, dealing around 51,400. The other Ethereum and everybody, all other coins, cryptos are also higher. It seems that last 3-4 days, even the dollar is stronger. Gold is moving up, trying to make a base around $1,740 per ounce. So that will be a critical area to watch it, but it's unable to cross 1760-65 also. That's important. Indian MPC 3 days meeting is starting today. broad expectations of market is that either they will hint or they will increase. I think they will increase maybe a 15 basis point on a reverse repo or maybe 35 basis point. As of now, market is looking that they will hint it on. We have seen, looking at these developments, short-term yields have moved higher. CPE rates, as I indicated yesterday also, they have hardened by 15-20 basis during the last week. 10-year G-Sec yield hardened by 3 basis to 6.26. This is an Indian yields I'm talking about, where the US 10-year yields have again crossed over 150 and trading around 153-154. Market will be definitely looking at a non-farm payroll numbers, which will be coming on this Friday. And there are expectations that those numbers would be 5 lakh plus. Yeah, thank you. Have a nice day, everyone.